What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 77 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Heart Gold. And in this episode, we're going to have a look at Mount Moon. And look who the cat dragged in. Thought we took care of this guy at Clefairy Road. Looks like we're going to have to go one more round with him. Pretty much got the same team as last time. We're gonna start off with Sneasel, his dark ice Pokemon. Pretty quick on the draw. I think I'm gonna need to pull a switch here though. Let's get in Heracross. With it being ice dark, it's got a double weakness to fighting. Here comes Shadow Claw. Not too bad. This has got to be a one-hit knockout here. There you go. Okay, one down, five to go. I think that's going to put Heracross to 52. Not quite. Yeah, because Gyarados had his hand in that battle as well. Alright, it's Espeon's turn. We're going to be taking on Golbat next. Surprised Silver has not gotten that up to a Crobat. Probably because he's been losing to me so many times, he couldn't get the happiness of Golbat to an all-time high. And that's the reason why. Now we got Gengar to deal with. Not taking any chances, we'll leave Espeon in. Let's see if we can take it out with Psychic. Honestly, anybody else would probably take some serious damage, but not Espeon. Quick enough and powerful enough to get Gengar down one shot. And now we got Feraligatr to deal with. See how Feraligatr likes Discharge. And we'll chalk up another 2 EV points in attack and 1 in defense for Ampharos. Also, chalk on a level for him, now at level 52. Got a good boost in HP there. Now we got Alakazam to deal with. Espeon honestly only has the effective weapon to go against Alakazam here. This is going to be kind of like fighting Gengar, except we're going to need Shadow Ball, which I don't know for sure if it's going to be a one-hit knockout. We'll see in a moment. Not quite. But it did knock down Special Defense. So I may be able to take it down with another one. I was actually thinking that Silver would use a full restore, but apparently not. Not even sure if he even has any full restores. Anyways, now we got Magneton to deal with. I'll have Typhlosion take this one out. Eat my flamethrower. Alright. We remain undefeated against Silver. We actually remain undefeated overall. I have not lost a single trainer battle since this LP began. So yeah, now Silver will be at Dragon's Den on certain days of the week. And you can battle him as many times as you want. But I think only once a day. Gyarados just gave me a round pebble. Anyway, this is Mount Moon. It's significantly smaller than what it was in Red and Blue. While Pokemon are in the single digits now. I believe that ladder will take me immediately out of Mount Moon. I'm gonna go ahead and burn a Max Repel here so I don't have to deal with these guys. Because there's one thing I do want to show here. I'm playing this game on a Monday. And you only get this event to occur on a Monday. It's the Clefairy Dance. Okay, so that's the way out. That'll eventually take us to this Ruby C. We'll do that route later. So I think I have to go back to that other ladder. Anything up here? Yes, a max revive. Good thing I came up here. It looks like there's a shop here, however it's closed. I guess it's only open during certain hours of the day. That'll take me back into the cavern. But here is the Clefairy Dance. Oh, Gyarados, that ugly mug of yours just scared off the Clefairy. But they did leave something behind. And we've got a Moonstone. You can come back here any Monday, and all you gotta do is watch the dance, and you get yourself a Moonstone. Doesn't appear to be anything else here. The desk machine's not picking anything up. So back downstairs we go. We're done with Mount Moon. I know it's a very short area. So we're going to do that route leading to Cerulean Sea, because we haven't covered this yet. This was a one-way route. And then once I get to Cerulean Sea, I'll end the episode. Alright. Let's get girls. We got one Pokemon. It's a Flaffy. Pokemon we're very familiar with. Ampharos used to be a Flaffy. So let's give it an Earthquake. Simple enough. And I believe that was her only Pokemon. Okay. And I do believe there are a few hidden items here. Yep, right here, we got ourselves an Ultra Ball. Add one more to our collection. This guy looks like a bird trainer. But I'm going to let Typhlosion take this one, just in case I may be wrong here. Well, he was a bird trainer, okay. Let's just start with a Pidgey. At level 13. Okay, either this guy is extremely weak and has been misplaced, or he's got something big waiting in the wings. Easy victory there. And it's gonna go right for Pidgeot. Pidgeot is 3 EV points in speed. Let's see how it likes my Blast Burn. No match for the Blast Burn. Is that going to be enough for a level up? Oh, just barely missed it. And we'll get it next battle. I'll probably just have Typhlosion lead off. Garzel's a big mushroom. We can go ahead and sell that. This is a very short route. Now, I believe I can only get that. Oh, I can go around and get that item. I was worried I would have to go off to the Cerulean cave path and go around to get it. Well, this shy young trainer is going to come at us with a ferret. This should be a relative cakewalk here. And this should put me at level 54 when we're done. And there we go. Now we got Rapidash. Okay, this could be tricky, but with the right Pokemon, it will be just another victory for me. He may be quick, but you'll go down to any one of these attacks. Except for maybe Ice Fang. You may have a shot against that. And Rapidash is all washed up. Okay, let's go ahead and grab this item. We got an HP up. And if I go south again, then that's gonna put me on the route to Cerulean City. I don't think there's anything else here. And we're back at Cerulean. Didn't take too much damage, so I'll go ahead and stock up on some supplies here. Also get rid of some stuff I don't need. I must have a lot of money right now. I'm over 200k right now, and that total will be growing. Whoa, I didn't want to sell that. Plus, I could only get 100 for that. Now, I did a little research on that Sacred Ash, and unfortunately, you cannot use it in the midst of a battle, nor can a Pokemon hold it. You can only use it when you're walking around. This guy doesn't have any Dusk Balls, so I'll go ahead and... I don't need any Quick Balls. Alright, well, I think I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. I'm going to head back to Pewter. Next episode, we'll head south into the Viridian Forest for the first time. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.